Hello, Lakers Nation. Trevor Lane here from the Lakers Nation podcast and senior writer for LakersNation.com. We're continuing our preview of each Lakers player heading up to the start of training camp. Finally, we're getting so close. We are almost there. Lakers basketball is nearly back. We're going to be diving into each and every player today. We're talking about Talen Horton-Tucker, the Lakers rookie, the guy that was a bit of a surprise pick. See, here's the thing. The Lakers, in order to select Talen Horton-Tucker, they actually had to make a trade. And they were able to do that by making a deal with the Orlando Magic. They got the 46th overall pick in this draft by trading their 2020 second round pick plus cash. So they made that swap with the Orlando Magic, picked up the 46th pick. We had heard rumblings that this was probably going to happen, that they were going to buy their way back into the second round after they went ahead and traded their number 4 overall pick in the deal for Anthony Davis, that the Lakers would look to land some sort of cheap, cost-controlled rookie. They would bring him in and bring in somebody who they thought could help the team. Now, I was really surprised with the way they went, that they went with Talen Horton-Tucker. And look, don't get me wrong, that is nothing new. The Lakers have been an extremely difficult team to get a read on for years. They've been confusing draft experts for years now on who they would be taking. But still, I thought for sure, if they bought their way back into the second round, they would be looking for a more experienced player, somebody who had been in college for 3, maybe 4 years and was getting bumped back because of that, because sometimes teams undervalue players who have spent a little bit more time developing in college. They feel like they have less upside. The Lakers have historically swooped in on players like this, guys like Jordan Clarkson, guys like Larry Nance Jr. And yet here, the Lakers decided to go the complete opposite route. Instead of going for a guy who might be ready to be a plug-and-play type of player, someone who can come in and at least play a few minutes off the bench right out of the gate, instead they went with one of the youngest guys in the draft in Talen Horton-Tucker. Definitely a project, somebody who's going to take some time. But it's an interesting pick for a lot of reasons, and there's a lot to be excited about here. Now, unfortunately, we didn't get to see him during summer league. He had a stress reaction in his foot, but should be ready to go for training camp here. So Talen Horton-Tucker, he's 18. Like I said, incredibly young. The guy doesn't even turn 19 until a month into the season, till the end of November. So this is an extremely young player. He's 6'4" with a 7'1" wingspan. That's right. You heard that. A 7'1" wingspan, and he is 6'4". You think about the NBA right now, and you think about wing defenders, and you think about how wingspan is all the rage at this point. You need guards who can go and switch onto bigger players, and that's something that Horton-Tucker will be able to do because of his long arms that will give him the ability to go out and defend bigger players. Think about Avery Bradley, kind of similar thing here. He's 6'2", he's got a 6'7" wingspan. And that's what's allowed him to defend up a few positions every now and then. He was able to D up Klay Thompson a few seasons ago, back when Avery Bradley was with the Celtics. So this is the type of thing that the Lakers were looking for, a wing defender who can be very, very switchable. But Horton-Tucker brings some things to the offensive end, too. He's not the quickest player out there. He's not an explosive athlete, but maybe that'll come, right, as he develops, as he grows into his body, as he matures. Again, he's still just 18 years old. He's got plenty of growing left to do. But maybe he can become something on the offensive end as well, because he's got some passing tools to him. He's got the ability to pass the ball. He's not a point guard. I wouldn't confuse him there, but he's a wing who can also pass the basketball, and that's something that is going to be in high demand in the NBA. Teams are looking for wing players that can make smart decisions out there on the floor for their teams, so when defenders close out on them and they take a dribble into the paint, that they can make a smart decision. They can read the defense and find the open man. That's what offenses in the NBA are all about right now, making those kind of reads. And the belief is that Horton-Tucker will be able to do that. But again, extremely young, going to need a lot of seasoning to get there. Now, we also thought that for sure the Lakers would target somebody who was a knockdown three-point shooter. Horton-Tucker is not that. 31% from the college three right now, which is a much shorter three. However, if you watch his game footage, he looks very, very comfortable shooting threes. He showcased a few step-back threes or sidestep threes, almost a la James Harden. Not that I'm comparing him to James Harden, everybody, but he has taken a few shots like that, and he looks very, very comfortable doing it. He's pretty strong. He's able to get the shot up with ease. It doesn't look like it's a difficult shot for him. It's just a matter of getting that shot to drop a bit more frequently. And again, extremely young, plenty of time to work on things like that. Now, of course, the elephant in the room here, Talen Horton-Tucker, his agent, is Rich Paul from Clutch Sports. So how much of a factor was that? Is this the Lakers doing a favor to Rich Paul by selecting Talen Horton-Tucker? Or is Rich Paul doing the Lakers a favor and kind of giving them a little bit of a hint that, hey, this guy's being overlooked and he's probably better than people realize. And if you can get him now, you should do it. Could be a bit of both, really, but I don't think it's coincidence that he's a Clutch Sports client and he winds up on the Lakers, who have LeBron James, who is the Clutch Sports client at this point, along with, you know, Anthony Davis and, of course, also Kentavious Caldwell-Pope. So Talen Horton-Tucker, solid pick. I think it's interesting. It's not the way I thought they would go. I think he could be a really nice piece moving forward. There's some really intriguing parts to his game. He's got a lot of scoop shots in the paint, some up and unders that can allow him to finish over bigger defenders. That wingspan is incredible. His three-point percentage isn't great, but I like his mechanics. I like how easily he shoots the ball. So what should we expect from him this season? Nothing. Don't go into the season expecting anything from Talen Horton-Tucker. I've been saying it throughout this whole video. He's 18. Give him time to develop. Give him plenty of opportunity down in the G League. That's probably where he's going to spend most of his time. If he spends any time up in the NBA, that's just a bonus. Okay, he's going to need time to develop and figure out his role in the NBA. But eventually, he could be a nice 3-and-D wing type player who also has a little bit of playmaking skills. Some people have compared him to maybe like a Draymond Green style player, only more of a wing body. Again, not saying he's going to be Draymond Green, but that type of player, the guy who can do a little bit of everything, can play some solid defense, uses his length to contest shots. That's the type of player that they're hoping he will eventually develop into, but it's going to take time. Don't assume that he's going to step in and play for the Lakers right away. If he blows up and he somehow finds his way into minutes, that's great. But you look at who's in front of him right now. You've got veterans like Danny Green, like Quinn Cook, like Kentavious Caldwell-Pope. The list goes on. The odds of him getting minutes this season are very, very slim, but certainly someone to keep an eye on here in preseason, as well as during his time in the G League with the South Bay Lakers, because he's certain to get some minutes there. All right, guys, for more on Horton-Tucker and everything else going on in the world of the Los Angeles Lakers, head over to LakersNation.com. Make sure you follow us on social media at Lakers Nation on Twitter and Facebook, at Lakers Nation Official on Instagram, and, of course, hit that subscribe button on the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Till next time, see ya.